And welcome, grade 9 students. This is Teacher Dali, your math buddy for today. Come and join me as we explore the world of mathematics filled with fun and learning experiences. But before we start, get your paper and pen, and together we will love and learn mathematics right at the comfort of your home.
Let us discuss solving quadratic equations by extracting the square root. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to identify perfect square numbers and find the solutions or roots of the quadratic equation by extracting the square roots. In the previous video, we have discussed that quadratic equation is a second degree equation in one variable that can be expressed in the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, where a, b, and c are real numbers and a must not be equal to 0. Take note that ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0 is the standard form of quadratic equation. Remember that there are two classifications of quadratic equation. The first one is complete quadratic equation, considering that b is not equal to 0. For example, x squared minus 4x plus 1 equals 0. This is an example of complete quadratic equation, since we have x squared as the quadratic term, negative 4x as the linear term, and positive 1 as the constant term. Another example is 3x squared plus 2x minus 1 equals 0. 3x squared is the quadratic term, 2x is the linear term, and negative 1 is the constant term. Another classification is the pure or incomplete quadratic equation. So let's consider if b is not equal to 0. So what will happen if b will become 0? If b is equal to 0, meaning that the linear term is omitted. For example, x squared minus 4 equals 0. The linear term is omitted. We have x squared as the quadratic term and negative 4 as the constant term. Another example, 3x squared plus 6 equals 0. 3x squared is the quadratic term and 6 is the constant term. Here are some examples of perfect square numbers obtained from squaring a whole number. We have 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49, 64, 81, 100, 121, 144, 169, 196, 225, 256, 289, 324, 361, 400, 441, 484, 529, 576, and 625. Notice that the square root of a number is the value that, when multiplied by itself, gives the number. For example, 4 multiplied by itself, that is equal to 16. When we get the square root of 16, we'll give you 4. Here is the complete list of the square roots of perfect squares from 1 to 625. You can pause this video to take a look on the list. This time, we will find the square roots of the following numbers. So let's say we have the square root of 81. So what do you think is the square root of 81? Correct, it is 9. How about if we have here a negative number outside the radical sign? So we will get the square root of 25, that is 5, and affix the negative sign. So the final answer is negative 5. What if we have a prime number under the radical sign? So let's say square root of 5. Since 5 is not a perfect square, and when we get the square root of this number, we'll give you a decimal number. For this time, we will accept that our answer is still square root of 5. Next, what if we have a negative number under the radical sign? For this case, we can factor out negative 7 as 7 multiplied by negative 1. And take note that the square root of negative 1 is equal to I, which means it is an imaginary number. So therefore, we can write our answer as square root of 7i. Okay, next, how about if we have the square root of 15? How to find the square root of this number? So we are going to factor out 50, wherein one of the factors is a perfect square. So we have there 25 multiplied by 2. Then extract the square root of 25, which is 5. And then we have still square root of 2. So the final answer is 5 square root of 2. And for the last one, the square root of negative 8. So let's factor out negative 8. 4 multiplied by 2 multiplied by negative 1. Remember, we can extract the square root of 4, which is 2, and the square root of negative 1, which is I. So therefore, our answer is 2 square root of 2i, or it can be written as 2i square root of 2. Let's proceed to quadratic equations by extracting the square root. Take note that when we solve quadratic equations, this means that we are going to solve for the value of x, which is called the solution set or the roots of the quadratic equation. Quadratic equations written in the form x squared equals k, where k is the constant term, can be solved by applying the following properties. The first property, if k is greater than 0, meaning that k is a positive number, then x squared equals k has two real solutions or roots, and that is x equals positive and negative square root of k. Second property, if k is equal to 0, then x squared equals k has one real solution or root, and that is x equals 0. And if x is less than k, that is k is a negative number, then x squared equals k has no real solutions or roots, meaning that the roots are imaginary numbers. In solving quadratic equations by extracting the square roots, first, we have to write in the form x squared equals k. Take note that we can only use extracting the square roots when it is incomplete quadratic equation. That is, b is equal to 0 or the linear term is omitted. Step number 2, we have to apply the square root property. The square root property states that if x squared is equal to n, then x is equal to the positive square root of n or negative square root of n. For example, solve x squared minus 16 equals 0 by extracting the square root. First, write the equation in the form x squared equals k. To do that, apply addition property of equality. That is, x squared minus 16 plus 16 equals 0 plus 16. Simplifying that will give you x squared equals 16. Then, extract the square root. In extracting the square root, apply the square root property. So, square root of x squared is x, and the square root of 16 is positive and negative 4. We can write that as x is equal to 4 and x is equal to negative 4. So, we can say that the solutions or roots of the quadratic equation are positive 4 and negative 4. Verify if the solutions or roots are correct. If x is equal to 4, we will simply substitute 4 to the variable x in the original equation. That is, 4 squared minus 16 equals 0. 4 squared is 16, so 16 minus 16 equals 0. So therefore, 0 is equal to 0, and that is correct. If x is negative 4, substituting negative 4 to the variable x in the original equation, so negative 4 quantity squared minus 16 equals 0, negative 4 quantity squared is 16, so 16 minus 16 is 0, so 0 is equal to 0. That means your solution is correct. Example number 2. Solve x squared minus 11 equals 0. Write the equation in x squared equals k. Applying addition property of equality will give you x squared minus 11 plus 11 equals 0 plus 11. Simplifying that will give you x squared equals 11. Then, extract the square root. Applying the square root property, so square root of x squared is x, and the square root of 11 is equal to positive and negative the square root of 11. That is, x equals the square root of 11, and x equals negative the square root of 11. Therefore, the solutions or roots are square root of 11 and negative square root of 11. Let us verify our answer. If x is equal to the square root of 11, then the square root of 11 quantity squared minus 11 is equal to 0. So the square of the square root of 11 is 11. So 11 minus 11 equals 0. So 0 is equal to 0, and that is correct. If x is equal to negative square root of 11, substituting this to the original equation, so we have negative square root of 11 quantity squared minus 11 equals 0. So when we simplify, that is equal to 11 minus 11 equals 0, and 0 is equal to 0, and that is correct. Example number 3. Solve x squared minus 8 equals 0. Write in the form x squared equals k by addition property of equality. That is, x squared minus 8 plus 8 equals 0 plus 8. And that will give you x squared equals 8. Then extract the square root. Take note that 8 is not a perfect square. So we can factor out 8 where one of the factors is a perfect square. So square root of x squared is x, and factors of 8 we have 4 and 2. Now we can extract the square root of 4. The square root of 4 is 2. So, x now is equal to positive and negative 2 square root of 2. That is, x equals 2 square root of 2, and x is negative 2 square root of 2. Let us check if our answer is correct. If x is equal to 2 square root of 2, substituting this to the original equation, this will give you 2 is square root of 2 quantity squared minus 8 equals 0. Take note that the square of 2 is 4 and the square of square root of 2 is 2. So 4 times 2 minus 8 equals 0. So 4 times 2 is 8. So it will give you 8 minus 8 equals 0 and 0 is equal to 0. Next, if x is equal to negative 2 is square root of 2. From the original equation, we will substitute negative 2 is square root of 2. That is, negative 2 is square root of 2 quantity squared minus 8 equals 0. The square of negative 2 is 4 and the square of the square root of 2 is 2. So 4 times 2 minus 8 equals 0. Then 8 minus 8 equals 0 and 0 is equal to 0. Solve 2x squared plus 3 equals 39. Write the equation in the form x squared equals k. Applying subtraction property of equality will give you 2x squared plus 3 minus 3 equals 39 minus 3. Simplifying this will give you 2x squared equals 36. Then divide both sides of the equation by 2. So 2x squared divided by 2 is x squared and 36 divided by 2 is 18. Then extract the square root. The square root of x squared is x. Since 18 is not a perfect square, we are going to factor out 18, wherein one of the factors is a perfect square number. So we have 9 multiplied by 2. Then extract the square root of 9. So we have positive and negative 3 is square root of 2. So we can write it as x equals 3 is square root of 2 and x equals negative 3 is square root of 2. So these are now the roots of the quadratic equation. Verifying our answer, if x is equal to 3 is square root of 2, substituting this value to the original equation, we have 2 multiplied by the quantity of 3 is square root of 2 squared plus 3 equals 39. Simplify, 3 squared is 9 and the square of square root of 2 is 2. So that is 2 multiplied by 9 multiplied by 2 plus 3 equals 39. Simplifying this is 36 plus 3 and that is 39 equals 39. If x is equal to negative 3 is square root of 2, substitute to the original equation. So we have 2 multiplied by negative 3 is square root of 2 quantity squared plus 3 equals 39. So when we simplify this, we have to get the square of negative 3 and the square of the square root of 2. And that is 3 or negative 3 multiplied by negative 3 is 9. Square root of 2 multiplied by square root of 2 is 2. So simplify this part, we have 2 times 9 times 2 is 36. 36 plus 3 is 39. So 39 is equal to 39. And that's it. Now it's your turn. Get your paper and pen and do this activity. You can pause this video to do the activity. After doing the activity, you can submit your paper to your mathematics teacher. And that's for today, guys. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share. Again, this is Teacher Dali, your math buddy. Remember, practice makes perfect. Thanks for watching!
Thank you.